gonna get you started, man. I don't want that pitch. That's a bit too jazzy. We gotta lower it. Even though I hate muffling bass drums,
I'm gonna do it.
I think we're all set, Chris.
All right, let's start the show then, if that's okay.
Yes, sir.
All right, I'm gonna introduce you guys.
You can say whatever you want. Let it come from your heart.
I will.
All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Fulton Street Collective. Tonight we are proud to present the GREG ARTRY TRIO. As we do with all of our performances here, always accompanied by a visual artist. Tonight's visual artist is our old friend Alex Puryear. Give it up for Alex. Hey, Alex. He will be sketching and painting the band as they perform, and what's really cool is you can buy his artwork on the lower left-hand side of your, excuse me, the lower right-hand side of your screen, that is the virtual tip jar. Be generous, be kind, please tip the band, please tip the artist. If you like what you see and hear, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective. We're going to start the show. On bass is Joshua Ramos.
Yes,
Jeff Swanson on guitar.
Yeah.
And at drums and vocals, Greg Artry.
Thank you.
Joshua Ramos on bass. Let's just groove for a second. Touching you, wanting you with all my might. Oh, that's the time. Feel like making love to you. That's the time. Virtually, hope you're having a great evening. We're having a great time. Happy to be here. Feel blessed to be here and grateful for the opportunity. My name is Greg Archery, and this is my trio. These are my brothers, and we're here to provide some music for you tonight. First song that we played, I guess made famous by Roberta Flack, and also D'Angelo, amongst others. Feel Like Making Love, it's a classic. And we're gonna move on to another classic that I actually was made privy to by a phenomenal trumpeter and composer and band leader. His name is Tom Harrell. And this is a song that's always stuck out to me because of how beautiful it is. I had a chance to hear his ensemble perform this live for the Chicago Jazz Festival some years ago. Esperanza Spalding sang lyrics to this song, and it was just gorgeous. We have a rendition for you today. The title of this song is Sail Away. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a beautiful song. Super beautiful. And now we're going to move on to something that's a little more familiar to the avid jazz listener. This song is like one of what we call standard by a great saxophonist named Wayne Shorter. The title of it is Yes or No, or Yes and No. I've heard it said so many different ways. However, as long as the melody is right. But we're gonna do it our own way. So again, Yes or No. Just wanna interject before we start again, how good it feels to play with my friends again. If you've seen me out recently, it's been after a pretty rough patch of life. I can say that I am here because of not only God's benevolent grace, but because of the love that has surrounded me from friends and family, and friends that have made themselves family. And, you know, including everyone here in this building, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the guy who introduced us tonight, Chris Anderson. Beautiful soul, beautiful guy, definitely was a huge help to me. So I'm grateful for this opportunity, grateful to be here. And it's just a ton of people that I don't want to start naming names because I don't want to come off as omitting people. But, you know, for all those who are close to me, you know me, you know that I love you all and really appreciate you all. And just grateful for this opportunity to be up and to be healthy, to drink a glass of water or to, you know, set up a set of drums. I don't take it for granted. So again, this next song is entitled Yes or No.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes or no? We're going to follow that song up. What a song. All these songs are very close to me, like personal in many ways. And this next one is no different. I started singing this song, I don't know how many years ago, and it was another, like, a favorite of mine, favorite artist of mine, and a favorite work of mine. And the artist's name is Sade. A lot of people are familiar with Sade. And if you aren't, then definitely check her out. Her music is so, it's so beautiful. It's like, to me, she runs in a lot of parallels to like Michael Jackson in the way that she made her music, or she makes her music, and that like the band is solid. The music is always rock solid. And the way she approaches singing a song is very much in tune with her spirit and very much in tune with the message that she lives. And but she explores like a variety of avenues as far as like style and even subject matter. And this song just stuck out to me because I'd heard it 1,000 times, but I never really heard it sung in a way that really put emphasis, a little more emphasis maybe, on the words. The words are very powerful. And it's a story about a young lady, young woman, who could be a young guy, I guess, here in this day and age, or anyone, however you identify. And young person who, in order to survive, had to sacrifice the integrity of herself. And from the outside looking in, it may seem like, wow, you know, this person is beautiful, this person is attractive, this person even has money, has affluence, you know, has the juice, you know. But there's a price to pay, and she was willing to pay it. So it kind of poses the question to me, interpreting it, like, what price am I willing to pay for the things that appeal to me in this world? You know, am I willing to sacrifice my integrity for this or for that? And I hope it poses that question to you, and I hope that you have the answer for yourself. The title of this song is Jezebel, and we're going to perform it for you now. Jezebel wasn't born with a silver spoon in she probably had less than any one of us. Jezebel, what a bell. She looks like a princess in her new dress. How did you get that? No. Do you really want to know? It would seem she's on her way. It's more, it's more than just a dream. Stockings and shoes, had nothing to lose. She said it was worth it. Reach for the top. She said, and the sun is gonna shine. Thank you.
She's already not listening.
But she says,
reach for the top. She said, and the sun is gonna shine. Winter was a war, she said, and I want to get what's mine. Jezebel, our pride. Oh, oh, oh.
Thank you very much. I really, 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 really like that song. It it's so deep, super deep. What are you willing to sacrifice for the things that you want? Is your integrity up there, you know? And it's a beautiful question to pose to ourselves. Now I'm just gonna, Chris, how many minutes we got left? Two, three? How much more time? Okay, I'm just gonna do a little thing, because I really enjoy playing the drums, and I also enjoy the singing, so I'm just gonna kind of do those two things in tandem. I remember when I was a kid, and my mom can attest to this, I used to sit literally in a shed and practice, and a beautiful way to practice this instrument was to be able to sing and play at the same time. It seems a lot more complicated than what it is, but it was a brilliant way for me to kind of learn how to accompany a singer and also like explore the freedoms that the drums don't immediately present. You know, they're perceived to be a lot more rigid than what they are. So to have the lyricism in the drums, you know, and a lot of the way that I would do that is just to play and talk. And it's fun, you know, because it uses both sides of the brain. And you can do some things, you know, free things.
Oh, no.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's keep the applause going for Greg Artry Trio. That's Joshua Ramos on bass, Jeff Swanson on guitar, Greg Artry on drums and vocals. We're going to take a short break. If you're watching, if you're in the house, we're going to turn up the lights, grab a drink, take a look at all the artwork around you, especially Alex's work, which is phenomenal right over here. If you're at home, you can do the same, but you have to pull out your fancy bank app on your fancy phone and tip the band first. So please be generous and kind. The tip jar is on the lower right-hand side of your screen. Do the right thing. Tip the band, tip the artist. All right, we'll see you in about 10 minutes. Stick around. Let's give it one more time for the band.
Yeah. your outfit, Chris. You're looking sharp today.
All right, we're back. Welcome to set number two with GREG ARTRY Trio. Give a warm welcome back to the stage, playing the bass tonight, Joshua Ramos. Jeff Swanson is on guitar. And on drums and vocals, Gregory Artry.
Hello, everyone. Thank you all for being here. We're very excited to play the second set for you all. We are mighty, and we are all important. And, I really have a lot of appreciation for Josh and for Jeff. We've done a lot of playing together, a lot of working together. They are my brothers musically and, you know, in a very heartfelt way, you know. And I'm very proud of what we've been doing. But I'm also proud of a bunch of people in the audience, people that I know. And I don't want to, you know, leave anyone out. So if I don't remember your name or anything like that, please just, you know, I've been flying all day. But, you know, somebody who's been a beautiful force in my life is here, Megan McNeil, an awesome vocalist and a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful person. And I'm very grateful for her. Another great friend of mine. We play at church, actually, together. And he is a phenomenal bassist and drummer, so I know he's going to be pointing out everything that I do wrong. But no, he's a great, great friend and a brother indeed. Mr. Brandon Bott is in the audience tonight, so I'm glad to see him. And another person who's a new friend, but a friend in the arts in a different medium. She's a phenomenal artist, painter, sketcher, you name it. She's done a lot of work that's hung up here in the Fulton Street Collective. And as Jess, she's sitting over there. How's it going? Phenomenal artist indeed. And it's just a bunch of people. Give it up to our artist for tonight. He has some incredible things cooking and brewing while we are up here cooking and brewing. So everybody's in the kitchen at the same time. Just really grateful for this space. Grateful for Chris Anderson, for the whole team, the whole staff that are here and who are curating an amazing experience. You know, they shared this throughout the pandemic, you know. My hat is definitely tipped to them for that because it takes a lot of courage to do that. And very grateful to be here. We're going to follow that song. It's titled Nothing Personal, a Brecker Brothers tune, classic. Also performed by many jazz artists thereafter. But that was our version, our rendition. We're going to follow that up with a beautiful ballad. And this ballad is titled Tenderly. And I want to dedicate this to a very, 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 very beautiful person, very special person. And she knows who she is. She's sitting in the front row. And this is for you. So here we go. Y'all wish me luck, because, you know, when the pressure is on like that, and there's only one way that this can go. This can do very well. Like, I can take a sip of this Tecate down here, and this can go really, really south, or it can go very well. So I'm banking on well. I think I need these. Thank you. evening breeze caress the trees tenderly. The trembling trees embrace the breeze tenderly. Then you and I came wandering by and lost in a sigh. Were we the shore was kissed by sea and mist tenderly. I can't forget how two hearts met breathlessly. Your arms open wide and close me inside. You took my lips, you took my love so tenderly. Swanson on the guitar. Oh, the shores were kissed by mist. Dee-doo-dee-da-doo-da-dee-da-da tenderly. I can't forget how two hearts met tenderly. Your arms open wide and close me inside. You took my chops away from pops so tenderly, so tenderly. You took my life, my heart so tenderly, so tenderly. You took my lips, you took my heart so tenderly. Oh. Oh, 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 oh. Thank you. You know, it's really a good thing. Love is okay, you know? It's an okay thing, right? It's okay to express it. It's okay to accept it. It's okay to, like, act in it. It's okay to be uncomfortable by it. It's okay to feel threatened by it, even. Just as long as you respond with love, I think that's the main thing. And I like the concept of love. I like talking about love because it's new to me. Like, so I was brought up in the era where it was like, boys don't cry, right? Boys don't express. Men don't share. You bottle it up and you keep it in and you be a man and you tough it out. But there's an imbalance in that, where there's a whole nother world of energy that's available to us as men when we learn how to express ourselves, to emote, to be empathetic, to be sensitive to people. Not a weak sensitive, but just aware, like aware of one another, aware of what's going on with one another, aware of what's going on with our women counterparts, because they're experiencing a lot, you know? They're dealing with a lot and processing a lot just to be around us, just to be with us, in relationship with us, or just to interact with us, you know? So there's a whole lot of processing going on. And when we as men open ourselves up to that, then there is just a whole universe available for us to be dynamic and powerful, to be impactful and heard, you know, not just listened to, but heard and treasured. So it's new to me. I'm moving in it a lot more now than I ever have in my life. And I owe that to a lot of beautiful women that have been in my world, my mother, first and foremost, you know, for giving me life, or for facilitating that process of me being on this planet, and for loving me unconditionally, no matter how much I smelled, or no matter what I said or what I got wrong. She was always, and has always, and will always be in my corner. So, and the list goes on, grandmothers, aunts, and a lot of mentors, even men who have shown that side of softness, you know, to encourage, as well as, like, you know, show that it's okay to cry, it's okay to express, it's okay to be weak, or it's okay to not have the answers. That's all okay, you know. It's a part of life, it's a part of living. So love is okay. Love is, it beats the alternative, that's for damn sure. So we'd like to move on to another song that I really enjoy because, not so much because of how great of a tune it is, but I enjoy it because, honestly, like, because of the person who showed it to me. And I dedicate this song to him, a brilliant trumpeter, gone way too soon, but he definitely gave me a crash course in the world of Brazilian music, in the world of Latin music, and his name was Claudio Roditi. I had a chance to play with him when I was very young. When I was in my 20s, I had cornrows and, you know, just completely out of character. And he said, "That's fine. Well, I'll show you. I'll show you what this music is all about." So he took me to go eat at Fogo de Chão. He took me to go eat at a bunch of different restaurants here in the city and introduced me to the Brazilian community. He showed me my first ever, like, walking into Logan Auditorium and seeing a whole sea of people, men and women, samba dancing, you know, and it was just like breathtaking. He was just, you know, just ushered me right in to that world of music. So I have a lot of respect for that, for that culture. And the name of this song is No More Blues, which is appropriate after a song called Tenderly, you know. So now, you know, the message of this song, and I learned this from a great friend and vocalist, Thomas Allen, is basically when you settle down, you won't have any more blues, you know. But as long as you're out here running around thinking you're big enough and bad enough to do whatever you want, then the blues will chase you, you know. So settle it down, Let's get it nice and relaxed into a place where the blues are no more. This is No More Blues. Thank you.
Thank you.
Give it up for Jeff Swanson on guitar and Josh Ramos on bass. These guys are incredible. I feel like I'm always surrounded by such incredible, talented human beings that, you know, I don't want to take it for granted, but it's just kind of like, yeah, they're my friends and they're also like amazing, you know?
It's because you're an incredible, talented
No,
human
stop, Josh. Well, thank you. You know, Josh and I have had this thing. Josh was the first bass player that I ever played with when I first came up to Chicago for a gig. It was at Pete Miller's in Evanston, and we were playing with Pharez Whitted and Ron Perillo on piano. And I remember that gig so strongly because Josh was, you know, like he is now, he's a strong man. You know, yeah. And, you know, I played with great basses before, but I never played with a basses where it was like, I play a little bit and lean into it, and he was like, oh, okay, cool. Start playing a little bit more and lean into it. And I was like, oh, shit. Play a little bit more and lean into it. He's like, yeah, it's fine. So it's always been like that. He's always reciprocated love and reciprocated the energy and the intent. And so here we are years later and playing. And Jeff's the same way. He's a warm-hearted man. It's always been encouraging, motivating. He's a band leader, artist, composer in his own right. We played a lot together, made records together, toured together. We've done all sorts of things together, just like, you know, as a team, we work together. And so he's also got some killing vegetarian, vegan recipes if you're ever interested. He can lay it down in a very special way. But that's not why we're here. We're here because of the music, and we're glad to be here because of the music. If you wouldn't mind, please give a huge round of applause to Fulton Street Collective as an entity. Everybody that's here, everybody that's running sound and video, to our artists in residence, our visual artists, for what he's creating. We really appreciate you and love you, man. I gotta come over and buy something. Hopefully it's within my budget. I wanna leave you with one final song. This is an original song that I wrote, and I'm a nerd at heart, at the core, and probably throughout. And I love, I'm kind of a weirdo, I love math, I love science. I love things that, you know, have, you know, like a scientific principle, but can also be applied to other areas of life. So we all know what black holes are, right? There's this huge enigmatic thing that we don't quite know what's on the other side of it, but it's shown that the reason why it's a black hole is because it's so dense that light can't escape from it. So we all know that part. There's another part of it where it's in the center of a black hole. This is what is called, like, there's different stages of it. There's an event horizon, and that's where, you know, matter as we know it pretty much ceases to exist. And then there's another place within it called a point of singularity. This is like theorized because none of us can ever see it or experience it and live to tell the tale. But a singularity is a place where space, time, all these concepts that we have to define our place and our lives, all those things cease to exist. All becomes one, and one becomes all. And I really apply that to the principle of love. Like, true love is a place of singularity. It's a place where it doesn't matter what you look like, what you smell like, what color you are, what you worship. It doesn't matter what you were born with, what gifts you were born with, what weaknesses you may see yourself as having. There's a place in love, a singularity in love, where all is one. And I hope to experience that in my personal world, in my personal life, in my personal love, as well as all over, You know, it's a challenge, but I think that challenges are very cool if they don't require you to break the law. And if you do have to break the law to show someone love, then what kind of law is it, right? So this song is titled Singularity. I'd be remiss to say that this song is coming out on an upcoming album project that I have. The title of the album will be Prevail, and it's going to be available very soon. So a lot of this original music is going to be on there. It's going to be totally original music, in fact, and good messages all around. So hit me up if you want to know more about that. Instagram is at Artry84, and I'll definitely be posting about it as it comes. So here we go. Yeah, pray for us. Sincere, her hair was strong and tight. She whispered in my ear something like, I am so in love with me, and I hope that you're in love with you too. Through the stormy seas, we will weather them with ease, 'cause I am so in love with you. Whatever we've got to do, together, baby, we won't lose. 'Cause when we lay entwined, I can feel your heart and mine, and I am so in love with the singularity between you. Here we go. I hold you all the time, your energy all white, you gleam for all to see. Strong and tight, she whispered in my ear something like, I am so in love with me, and I hope that you're in love with you too. Through the stormy seas, we will weather them with ease, 'cause I am so in love with you. And whatever we've got soul and mind, and I I hold you all the time. Your energy all white. You gleam for all to see, always. Don't you ever go away. I heard it once sincere. Her hair was strong and tight. She whispered in my ear something like, I am so in love with me. And I hope that you're in love with you too. Through the stormy seas, we will weather them with ease. 'Cause I am so in love with you, and whatever we've got to do, baby, together we won't lose. 'Cause when we lay entwined, I can feel your heart and mine, and I am so in love with the singularity. Thank you.
All right, that's Greg Artry Trio, everybody. That's Joshua Ramos on bass. Jeff Swanson on guitar. Paints, brushes, canvas. Alex Puryear. And leading the crew tonight on drums and vocals, Greg Artry. That's it for tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. If you're in the house, we're going to turn up the lights, take a look at Alex's work, which is phenomenal, and the work around you. And we have a Marissa Chavez sighting all the way back from the subcontinent. Wow, far out. Bet you don't know what I'm talking about online, do you? But if you are watching online, please be generous and kind. Please tip the band. You're watching in the comfort of your own home, so why not be generous, be cool, be kind? As Wilford Brimley used to say, it's the right thing to do.
Quiz!
All right, have a good night, everybody. We'll see you.